गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 10। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव कंप्लीटेड अवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ हिस्ट्री एंड इन टुडेज वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द सेकेंड चैप्टर ऑफ योर ज्योग्राफी विच इज फॉरेस्ट एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ रिसोर्सेज। ओके, इट इज फॉरेस्ट एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ resources. So let us discuss the chapter forest and wildlife resources, right? See, first of all let us discuss the point that what are the importance of forest and wildlife, right? Forest and wildlife, both of them are interlinked, right? If there will be a forest, then there will be a wildlife. If there will not be a forest, then there will not be a wildlife. जैसे हमारा एक सिटी होता है, सिटी के अंदर नॉर्मल सी एक सिचुएशन है कि सिटीज के अंदर इतने ज्यादा ट्रीज नहीं होंगे, सीमेंटेड रोड्स होंगी, सो इट इज नॉट अ पार्ट ऑफ फॉरेस्ट, और इसी वजह से यहाँ पे वाइल्ड लाइफ भी नहीं है, यहाँ पे वाइल्ड एनिमल्स आपको नहीं मिलेंगे। राइट, वाइल्ड लाइफ रेफर्स टू द एनिमल्स विच आर लिविंग फ्रीली, नॉट जस्ट द एनिमल्स विच आर कार्निवोरस विच ईट मीट एंड विच दे आर द प्रेडेटर ऑफ अनदर एनिमल्स, बट ऑल द अदर एनिमल्स विच लिव फ्रीली, राइट? वेदर इट्स अ डक, इट्स अ रैबिट, इट्स अ डियर, इट्स अ टाइगर, इट्स अ लायन, राइट? सो we means that forest and wildlife, when we say wildlife it means all the animals, right? So forests are one of the most important resources for a country and lives are usually dependent on them. Each species on earth is in some manner interdependent on various biotic and abiotic factors in the ecosystem of the earth as a whole, right? In the previous chapter we have already discussed about what is biotic or biotic and abiotic, right? Anything that comprises of the living animals or living thing, right? That is biotic, means biotic means living factors, and abiotic means non-living factors, right? And the life of any person depends on both these things, whether they are living or whether they are non-living. They are an important component of the ecosystem and are essential for the survival of other organisms. The ecosystem helps generate oxygen and provides food which is needed for life to survive on the planet. Forests are thus known as primary producers on which other organisms survive and live, right? So forests are, that is why, a basic necessity required by the animals and even us human beings, right? If we are getting timber, we are getting wood for our use, we are getting it from the forest. If there will not be any forest, then we will not be able to extract the wood, right? If we are getting other types of herbs, we are getting other types of medicinal plants, we are getting it from the forest, from the dense forest, right? So we are dependent on the forest, and that is the importance of the forest, right? Not only the wildlife, but human beings are also dependent on the forest. Now we will be discussing about the flora and fauna, that what is flora and what is fauna. These both things are found in the forest, right? So flora refers to the plants kingdom. You can remember it from flower. It sounds like flower, F-L-O-R-A, flora, and F-L-O-W-E-R is flower, right? So it is about the plants. And when we talk about the animals, it is the fauna. And these two terms are always said together that flora and fauna, right? Flora refers to the plants and fauna refers to the animals, right? So let us discuss that. The diversity in India's plains for the flora and fauna is very diverse, right? See, we have already discussed that this is the earth and this is the equator, right? These are the Tropic of Cancer and it is the Tropic of Capricorn. I have drawn this diagram many number of times in the class also. And this is your equator. The area between the equator and the tropics is called as tropical area, and the area from the tropics to the poles is called as your temperate area, right? So it is tropical and it is the area from here to here, it is temperate. The same goes for the southern hemisphere also, right? It is the northern hemisphere and it is the southern hemisphere divided by the equator. The area between the equator and the tropics means this area, the area lying between the two tropics is very much good for the survival of the animals, right? Because I have already discussed that the equator is the area where it receives most of the rainfall, right? It gets the highest sunlight on the earth, the equator area, and that is the reason that why it gets the most of the rainfall, right? So when the areas are getting most of the rainfall, this is the reason that why the areas having most of the rainfall have the dense forests, and when there are dense forests, then there will be dense wildlife, because there only the animals will be getting their means for survival, right? There only the food chain can survive easily. So India also lies within the tropical area, right? So that is why it is neither too hot like the equatorial region nor too cold like the poles. Yet it has a diverse tropical mix which includes high altitude mountains, plains, as well as coastal areas and the coastline, right? If we draw the figure or rough figure of India, then it is India. Right. So in the northern area, we have the mountains. In the western part, we have desert area. Here we have the coastline, right? And on the coastline also, there is a large amount of diversity found. So, and this diversity allows for the different types of animals and different types of plants. Biodiversity implies to variety of life and the variation within species found in the specific region. By the definition, India has inheritance of biodiversity because of the geographical location of India. India have abundant amount of biodiversity here. There are approximately 47,000 species of flora. For flora, there are 47,000 species. And for fauna, that is for animals, we have around 81,000 species of fauna. Okay, for flora it is 47,000 and for fauna it is 81,000, right? In addition to those permanently located in this region, large number of bird species also migrate and come to parts of India during the extreme winters in the northern latitude, right? So when there are winters in the northern area of the earth, the many of the birds come to India for migration because they are in search of food. They come to India for that. Okay. With ever increasing industrialization and urbanization, destruction of forest and pollution of water bodies, a large number of animals and plant species are endangered, and some are on the verge of extinction. We all know that there is a large amount of urbanization, industrialization, for which we have to cut down the trees. There will be pollution also when the industries will be running. And this is the reason that why the biodiversity of India, which includes 47,000 species of flora and 81,000 species of fauna, are getting disturbed by the process. In the process of urbanization, or we can say in the process of industrialization, these industries and the cities, they damage the biodiversity, right? And this is the reason that many species are getting endangered. The term is endangered, right? And some are on the verge of extinction. So we will discuss about this in the next video, what is endangered and what is extinction in detail. But for now, you can understand that being endangered or on the verge of extinction means that the number of animals within that species are getting rare, right? They are found very less in numbers, right? So right, like there is tiger. The tiger is listed under the category of endangered species, or either it can be said that it was on the verge of extinction, right? So endangered means ki ek species hai, say tiger, aur uske bahut hi kam individuals ya fir jo hai bahut kam tigers jo hai reh gaye hain today at present time, that is endangered, right? And extinction means that not a single species, not a single unit of that species present. Like dinosaurs, ki dinosaurs kya extinct ho gaye, aaj humko ek bhi dinosaur earth ke surface pe nahi milega. That is extinction. And endangered means that they are being found, but they are very rare, right? That is extinct, that is endangered. So because of the process of industrialization, the species are being endangered and on the verge of extinction, right? And that is why we have discussed, we will be discussing about the endangered species or the extinct species or other classifications which are done by the authorities or other organizations so that they can save the biodiversity of any place, not just India, of any country. Okay, students, so we will meet in the next video. Till then, stay at your homes and stay safe. Thank you.